Design of steel structure. This is your lab design of steel structure, and the lab code is 001009. So today we will see the what you have to draw a sketch in sheet number 4. Only few students they have submitted the sheet number 3. We will extend the time due to your examination. When will be your regular examination for AC? हेलो,
यस सर।
रेगुलर एग्जाम आपका कब से है एसी का?
सर एसी का एक एक तारीख से 5 तारीख तक बैकलॉग है और 6 तारीख से 10 तारीख तक रेगुलर है, एंड सेम।
10 तारीख तक रेगुलर है क्या?
हाँ सर, एंड सेम।
6 तारीख यदि फ्राइडे से शुरू होगा पहला पेपर।
यस सर।
फ्राइडे सैटरडे 8 को संडे को पेपर है?
नहीं सर, अगस्त आप जुलाई का दिखा रहे हैं सर। अगस्त
अगस्त ही देख रहा हूँ मैं बेटा, मैं अगस्त
सॉरी
देख
सर।
रहा हूँ। 8 तारीख को संडे है ना?
हाँ 6 तारीख। हाँ
6 तारीख फ्राइडे आ रहा है
यस सर।
तो 6, 7, 9, 10, 11 तक है क्या?
नहीं सर, 10 तक है।
तो यानी संडे को भी पेपर है?
यस सर।
6, 7, 8, 9, 10 और उसके बाद फिर आपके बाद एफी का शुरू होगा क्या?
नहीं सर, एफी के हो गए।
एफी को हो गए
यस सर।
बैकलॉग भी?
नहीं सर, वो नहीं पता, लेकिन रेगुलर वाले एफी के हो गए सर।
ट्यूजडे तक आपका नेक्स्ट वीक में रहेगा। 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 15 तारीख संडे 15 अगस्त। ओके, वी विल कंटिन्यू एंड दिस इज योर फोर्थ प्रैक्टिकल इन डिजाइन ऑफ स्टील स्ट्रक्चर लैब। देयर इज द कोड ऑफ योर दिस इज इनसो 301009। ओके, तो दिस sheet number 4 contains of again you have to draw in sheet number 4 you have to draw the four sketches of slab base. First part slab base, these are the type of column base, and then gusseted base, and then industrial building, component of industrial building, that is general type, and then pre-engineered building, that is called as PEB structure, PEB building, PEB structures. Okay, so these four sketches you have to draw on sheet number your four, sheet number 4 of your term of part A. Part 1 say, or part A say, with whatever you will say. So your design of steel structure. So the column bases. Generally, we have to avoid the column bases because in a steel structure, the column is very slender and very thin sections are there. It may be I section, it may be channel section, it may be four angle section, it may be two channel section. But you can see this cross section dimension of the section in steel structure is very less as compared to the other members. So that if we rest the column डायरेक्टली ऑन द कॉन्क्रीट और ऑन द ब्रिक मैसनरी और तो व्हाट हैपेंस देयर विल बी चांसेस ऑफ पंचिंग शियर फेलियर और इट विल बी ब्रेक द कॉन्क्रीट बिकॉज द बियरिंग स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट इज वेरी लेस इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर M20 ग्रेड ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट सो जस्ट वी आर टेकिंग द स्ट्रेंथ वी आर कंसिडरिंग 0.45 यानी 4.45 ऑफ योर FCK सो इट इज कमिंग जनरली 9 Newton per mm square as compared to the steel strength it is very less the bearing strength of concrete is very less and that may be not able to taking the load and the foundation will be maybe fail so that to transfer the column load to transfer the column load this is the your column to transfer the column load the column below the column there is providing a base plate and these base plate are called as column bases okay so this is your foundation okay it may be concrete it may be another type of structure so that this column load do not directly can provide over the concrete because the bearing strength of the concrete and brick work or block work very less so that's why this plate is voiding and this plate is having steel plate and if only plate is voiding below the column then that is called as slab base and if the heavy load is there additional plate are required with the column to distribute the large load then that is called as gusseted base and this moment and also there is moment resistingness for there is moment on the column so there the column bases there is around two types slab base gusseted base and you have to draw in sheet number 4 of part 1 that is first sketch with the slab base and slab base only the axial load is acting on the slab base and there is no moment okay so this you can see in slab base only you can see that this is the column this is your column okay this one is your column this is just supporting angle it is sometimes it is called as cleat angle to hold the column and then this is holding down bolt to hold the column in position called as holding down bolt so to connect the plate with the foundation so you can see here the concrete pedestal this is the concrete pedestal over the concrete pedestal your base plate is there and this base plate is the steel base plate okay the material is the steel because bearing strength of concrete is very less so steel base plate is voided so only base plate is voided in the slab base so only base plate is there and then or supporting angle the supporting angle to hold the column in position and this is the web creep the web angle is provided and this is called as web creep and this is also it may be welded or bolted any type of connection you can call it okay so you can see here this is the concrete over there there is the steel base plate and over that your column this column is resting this is your column So your column is resting on the base plate because the cross section dimension of column you can see it is very less and the bearing strength of concrete is also very less so this may the load is heavy of the column and that may be pointing in or maybe प्रोड्यूस अ क्रैक और फेलवर ऑफ द फाउंडेशन में ऑकर ड्यू टू द स्लेंडर नेस ऑफ योर कॉलम और वेरी लेस बियरिंग एरिया फॉर द कॉलम. तो कॉलम में भी पंच इन एंड दैट्स व्हाई टू अवॉइड दिस फेलवर वी आर अवॉइडिंग द बेस प्लेट. तो योर कॉलम लोड इज ट्रांसफर टू द बेस प्लेट एंड थ्रू बेस प्लेट इज ट्रांसफर टू द योर फाउंडेशन और पेडिस्टल. ओके, so this is nothing but the simply the slab base. In slab base only base plate is there, you should remember that, and the web grid and the flange grid or anchor is providing for holding down the column in position. Only for that we are not transferring the load, we are not transferring the load. So this is the you know that this is the in this from this way you can transfer the column load to the foundation through the slab base and for the column with axial load, with column with live load, you can say column with axial and axial and light load. Not too heavy load on the column is there, then we have to provide the slab base. Okay. And when there is a heavy load or medium load, any small moment is there on the column. So what happens? The load is large and there is moment. Small moment is also there. And when we provide the only slab base, the thickness of slab base will be uneconomical. So. To distribute the load on the large area, so additional plate are joined with the column. So in this picture, you can see, show to enlarge this view. You can see in the elevation, it is visible to you, I think so, clearly. So you can see here, this one is the column. In earlier case, in our slab base, what we have seen in slab base, only column is there. And column is there, and below the column only base plate is there. Okay, and this base plate is holding down bolts. Okay, and this is the column, and then your load is transferred to the concrete pedestal or the foundation. Okay, so this is your in case of your slab base. In case of slab base, so this you can say it is the for the slab base. Okay, so this is for the this is the column base. It is nothing but you can say the slab base because there is no additional lumber attached to the column, and simply this one is the column. Column, and to put the column in a position, we are providing the web grid or grid angle. Okay, so web grid we are providing, or some supporting angles are provided with the flange also. So this is the simply the slab base connection. So this one is the base grid. Okay. So only column transfer the load, axial load, through the base plate to the foundation. It is the slab base. Okay. Now, in case of, you can see here, what is the difference between the earlier and this one? There is holding down bolt. Yes, you are showing the holding down bolt. Holding down bolt. Down bolt. But here you can see the large load is there, and there is load as well as there is small movement in the column, so that they need additional plate, additional area to transfer them. So you can see this column is attached with the gusset plate. We have written this one is the gusset plate. Okay, the column with additional gusset plate, and then additional flange grid angle is also called as gusset angle. see also this flange grid angle is also called as gusset angle, is also connected. So these gusset angle and gusset plate and column, these three combining, they will transfer the load to the foundation. Okay, so that this thickness of base plate is reduced. So this base plate thickness will be reduced. So समझ में है कि यहाँ पर क्या हो रहा है, इस कॉलम के साथ साथ एडिशनल गसेटेड मटेरियल वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग एंड दिस गसेटेड मटेरियल इज नथिंग बट द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दिस गसेट प्लेट एंड द गसेट एंगल. ओके, यू कैन से दिस इज द गसेट मटेरियल एंड दे आर अटैच विद द कॉलम एंड द लोड इज ट्रांसफर ऑन द लार्ज एरिया सो दैट द थिकनेस ऑफ बेस प्लेट रिक्वायर्ड इज लेस एंड ऑल्सो इज or heavy load or medium load, you can go for this type. If load is there, actual load and moment, you can go for the gusseted base. Okay, so this figure you have to draw the slab base first. This slab base you have to draw, and then second you have to draw this gusseted base. Okay, so what is different with the gusset base? There is this gusset plate additional. So you can see here is this gusset plate. You can see the inclined portion, and this one is the this is the gusset angle. This one is the gusset angle. You can see here in the elevation, side elevation. Okay, and then again holding downwards, you can see here the side it is placed, and this is your column. Okay, so likewise, if you are providing the gusset material with the column and then transfer load through the base plate to the foundation, then that type of column base is called as gusseted base. Okay, so generally there is three types of base plate are there. If you column bases, if you go for column bases, so there are three types. One is the slab base for axial load. Second is the gusseted base. When you add a gusset material to the column, and this is for axial load and light moment, and then there is moment resisting bases are also there. Resisting bases are also there. So when you study the column bases, you will come to know all these things. So in sheet, you have to draw only the slab base sketch and the gusseted base sketch as given in this sheet. And mainly, sir, you can download from the internet also. If you type here gusseted base, gusseted base, then many such images will be internet available. You can see and you can draw any one of the figure which you like. Okay. Here, the technical specification of the gusseted base plate is also given, so such that you can download and you can draw the sketch of it. So this will be the gusseted base. Then the this one is the second sketch. First is the slab base, and second sketch is the gusseted base. Okay, so any one of figure you can draw or you can search on internet also. Then on sheet number 4, the part 3 or third figure you have to draw is the components of industrial building. Okay. So there are such many industrial buildings. Previously you have seen this type of building. You can see on the bay or old structure there are the truss is there, large slope is there, and then roof sheeting. This is the roof sheeting, roof covering. This is roof covering. Okay, this is the ridge, the topmost portion, and at the column this is called as eaves. Okay, and this is the spacing of the truss. And this one truss and another truss between two distances called the spacing of the truss. And the purlin, problem we are supporting the roofing sheet. Okay, then this is the point where the members meeting, the purlin is resting and the members are meeting, is called as the final point. Okay, so these are the final points on the roof truss where the purlin load and roofing sheet load are concentrated, and then you are designing the truss. Okay, so this is this distance, this is called as tie member in truss, and then there is part of the truss, and there is spacing between the purlin. This is the spacing between the purlin. Okay, so this is the general building, this component of part of your industrial building. So here you can see the column is there. On column the truss is resting, and maybe if you require, then there is, you can provide a bracket, and over the bracket the gantry girder is there, and then over the gantry girder your gantry will run to lift the heavy load. Okay, that part we will cover later on. So here you have to draw this component parts of general industrial building. It's more visible. Okay. So all these terms, you have to draw the component parts of the industrial building, and tie rod and sag rod and all these things you have to write down. And if you search on internet also, you can search the components of the steel building. So industrial building. So many such images and videos will come. Okay. So these are the PV structure. Don't go for the PV structure. In general building, your first you have to draw the components of general building, and then you have to go for the PV structure also. Okay. So general layout of building is not same, because most of nowadays the structure is built with the PV structure, and the most photographs of PV structures are available on the internet. These all you are seeing are the PV structure. Okay. So the component of industrial building, you can see this is also the PV structure. So mostly there is the PV structures. Okay. So it may be given in the your SK Google book, and previously for such component parts of the general building, general industrial building previously used. You have to see, and then you have to go for the PV structure. So here this column is there, below column there is slab base or column base. We have the column bases, then pedestal is there. Okay, the pedestal, or it is a column. This is the base plate. You can see the column base. All this thing you have to design also in project part. So this is your column. And here, in parallel to this, there are member, and they are called as the beam or girder. And these are the truss. This whole part is called as truss, and this is the purlin. This purlin over the roof truss. So if this is one truss, this is the second truss. So over the two truss, this is the purlin. This one is the purlin, and over purlin, the roofing sheet is deployed, and this is the roof. And the side beam, side colliding beam, is also called as gird. Side colliding beam, we are sheeting, you are providing side sheeting, you are providing. If you are providing the side sheeting, then that beam is called as GIRT, gird. Okay, if there is no one, okay, there is no one. If war is there, no need of war providing besides ship. Okay? So this is the general component of your industrial building that you have to draw on your sheet number 4. Okay, then you have to then in the component part of truss, you can say truss generally any type of track truss or heavy truss. You learn this type of truss is generally used nowadays. This may be called as the track truss. It is starting from the tie. So this is nothing but it is called a tie member of your truss. Okay. And this is called as compression member. Generally, you know, gravity load is called as rafter. And this vertical member is called as ceiling. Maybe tension or compression based on the shape of truss. And the inclined member, they are called as strut. It may be tension. Strut is generally the compression member. It may be vertical or inclined based on the truss. And here is a support from the column. So here you have column is there, okay, for the industrial building. And over this point or junction, the beam is running, and that is called as purlin. So purlins are running like this, okay. So they are. In Gulu, you can say it is called as purlin, and over purlin there is a roofing sheet you are required. Okay, so this is nothing but the component part of the truss. This is the component part of your truss. And then additionally, you can draw the column. You draw the column inside purlin is called as gird, and then sheeting, side sheeting, etc. These are the in general component parts of your truss, and then your foundation, base plate and foundation is there. Okay, base plate. And below that, your pedestal foundation generally, because steel is corroded earlier, very reactive with the soil, there is a sulfur or carbon, and that's why moist condition is there below the subsurface soil. That's why we are avoiding the foundation with steel structure. Generally, conditions are generally nowadays only voided by the concrete or wood or another type of masonry structures or stone. Okay, and then above that you are going for the streets. So these are the component parts of your industrial building, regular building or general building. You have to draw on sheet number 4, third sketch. Okay. Then sheet number 4, the fourth sketch, you have to draw the component part of the pre-engineer building. So this is the pre-engineer building. Pre-engineer building, why it is called a pre-engineer building? Because these buildings are made in the cutting in light sections, and as per the requirement, the sectional dimension are provided. Where is the forces coming and where the moment is large and forces are large, their cross section dimension of the member is based on the moment diagram or shear force diagram based on that. So if you come to the component parts of the pre-engineered building here, visible to you. So here, this one is will start from the top. This one is called as the ridge. Okay, this one is the ridge belt, ridge. ridge, it is called as ridge. Then this is the fascia for attractive look of your building. Attractive look building, you're providing the fascia so that the behind roof will not be visible. And this is the roof panels. Okay, roof panels are there. And then here you can see the rafter. This one is the rafter. Okay, I will write here rafter. This one is the rafter. And over rafter there is purlins. So this small portion you can see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All these things are purlins. I will write the thing. Okay. So these are the purlins. Okay. Over purlin your roofing sheet are there. Okay. So this purlin is there, and then for opening for the skylight on the for light in the inside the existing building. Then at the end there is for rainwater collection there is gutter, and here you can see this side purlin of the column for side seating. This is called as the gird, and this is the your rafter, and this one is your column. So generally you can see this one is your column in three area building. So generally you can see the column size will be like at this portion. This is going for the rafter, and here it is connected with the column. So generally you can see the dimension of column at the bottom is less. Okay. Because the moment here is large, this portion where the connection between the rafter and column is there, the moment is large, so that their cross section is also large, and as bottom you are telling, the section is reducing. So as per the stress on the column, as per the stress on the column, you can see that this cross section is provided for the column. So that is generally in pre-engineering, there is type of section as per the stress diagram, the section is provided. So as per requirement, as per the forces acting, we are reducing the section so that we are cutting actually the cost of your construction in the PV. Okay, and that's why this is still the clause for the PV building in India is not available, but we are using the US on STM code, the American code, for design of this PV building on Euro code. Okay, so they and it is not necessary, just getting you will follow the code. Codes are provided only for the guideline for the structures. So this in sheet number 4, you have to draw these four figures. Just now we have discussed. That is, first one is first you have to draw the slab base. First you have to draw the in column bases. You have to draw the slab base. So how to draw slab base? This figure is here for the reference. It is given. You may draw better than this. Then the column bases. May second type is the gusseted base. When the gusseted material is attached for heavy load of column to transfer the load to the foundation through the base plate. If you will not provide the gusseted material, then thickness is uneconomical for the base plate. So that's why the gusseted material is attached, and that is also good for resisting the light movement on the column. If movement and axial load both are there, then you need the gusseted base. Or moment resisting base, if moment is not. Okay. Otherwise, if axial load is there, then base plate, slab base is enough for transferring the load. Okay. Then the unit plate is provided and supporting angles are provided. So, this is the gusseted base, that second part as we discussed. Okay. You have to know. Then, the component part of the industrial building, that is regular building, which were construction. Before the pre-engineered building, nowadays all the buildings generally you can see the pre-engineered building. And earlier photograph of our this practical before. So you can see that on the front only, this is the regular building behind the student. You can see these are the regular buildings. Okay, it is certainly, but there is open inspection. No side cladding is provided because this is the ginning mill for the cotton. They are collecting and then storing only to remove the moisture by the sunlight or by the heat. That's why we are providing openly, no covering is there. Okay, so this is general regular building, you can say, and this is the PED structure. So many such PED structural component building you can see on the internet available, and their component parts are written with one number is the U. You can see the one number, very common here, U. After second number is after. Third number, hetero, okay, hetero. Over rake, trim, corner trim, side trim, wall girth, all these things are the component parts of your PVD structure. Any one of this you can see, this is also another type of your industrial building PVD structure. Okay, now this is your sheet number 4. कोई डाउट है शीट नंबर 4 में तो आप पूछ सकते हैं मुझसे. समझ में आ गया सबको शीट नंबर 4 पे क्या ड्रॉ करना है? यासिर कितने शीट हो गए आपके? सॉरी यासिर, मोहम्मद सोले
सर दो ड्रॉ कर चुका हूँ.
दो ड्रॉ कर चुके मोहम्मद सोले. और आपके जो दोस्त हैं वो लोग जो ज्वाइन नहीं कर रहे लेक्चर प्रैक्टिकल, क्यों नहीं ज्वाइन कर रहे? क्या प्रॉब्लम है? उनको ऑनलाइन लेक्चर में मजा नहीं आता है, सीखना नहीं है उनको, क्योंकि समझ में नहीं आता है कि घर बैठे बैठे आपको सीखना है, उसमें आपको दिक्कत हो रही है. कॉलेज आ रहा नहीं है, कहीं जाना नहीं है. अभी कॉलेज ओपन हो जाएगा तो फिर आना पड़ेगा, फिजिकल अटेंडेंस होगी, डेली अटेंडेंस आपका रिकॉर्ड हो रहा है. मैं डेली ऑनलाइन अटेंडेंस रिकॉर्ड करके रहता हूँ गूगल शीट में. तो आप लोग इसको इजी कर लीजिए. आपके जो फ्रेंड है, जो दोस्त है, वो लोग अगर ज्वाइन नहीं कर रहे, रेगुलर काम नहीं कर रहे, उनका नुकसान हो जाएगा. फिर समझाइए, और अगर जितनी जल्दी हमारा काम होता है तो दैट इज वेल एंड गुड फॉर योर स्टडी. आप दूसरा काम कर सकते हो, फोकस कर सकते हो, कुछ रिसर्च वर्क करने में, कुछ इन्वेंशन करने में, कुछ पेपर प्रेजेंटेशन या प्रोजेक्ट कॉम्पिटिशन में आप हिस्सा ले सकते हो. लेकिन प्रोवाइडेड दैट यू विल डू रेगुलर लेक्चर एंड यू विल फिजिकली विद क्लास विल स्टार्ट यू विल प्रेजेंट इन कॉलेज रिव्यू. ऑनलाइन लेक्चर में नहीं आते हैं तो फिजिकल क्लास में कैसे होंगे? और मैं भी दे आर थिंकिंग दैट ऐसे चलता रहेगा. योर योर पेरेंट्स आर पेइंग फॉर योर लर्निंग एंड यू विल बी बिकम द इंजीनियर. तो आपको सिखाया जा रहा है तो कॉलेज जो आपको ऑनलाइन सिखाया जाए या कॉलेज में सिखाया जाए, जो लेक्चर में आपको जो समझ में आएगा आप पढ़ के उसको 10 times टाइम लगेगा आपको. दैट्स व्हाई व्हेन यू स्टडी एट होम आल्सो लेक्चर आप करते हो तो आपको कम टाइम लगेगा समझने के लिए. और डिफिकल्टी जब भी वाली होगी व्हेन यू आर ज्वाइनिंग द लेक्चर एंड व्हेन यू आर स्टडिंग. तो अभी आज तक क्या मैंने तकरीबन 3 शीट 4 शीट का समझा दिया है? चौबीस शीट है. अगर इसमें आपको कुछ दिक्कत है, अगर समझ में नहीं आया तो आप मुझसे पूछ सकते हैं. इससे पहले की भी शीट में अगर कोई शीट ड्रॉ करने में आपको कुछ प्रॉब्लम है, कुछ पूछना है तो आप पूछ सकते हैं. आप जो भी क्वेश्चन अगर प्रैक्टिकल अवर्स में पूछते हैं या लेक्चर अवर्स में, तो उससे दूसरों का भी फायदा होता है. बोलिए, एक ट्रेन बनाइए आप. राहुल कितने शीट हो गई आपकी?
दो. दो सर.
कैमरा ओपन नहीं करते आप लोग, ऐसी बात करते हो, क्या प्रॉब्लम है? मोहम्मद सोले आपकी कितनी सीट हो गई?
सर दो सीट हो गई है।
अच्छे से ड्रॉ करो उसको, चेंज करवाओ जब भी कॉलेज आते हो।
सर दोनों गूगल क्लासरूम पे अपलोड हो चुकी है।
अपलोड हो गई है ठीक है, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, लेकिन अगर आप कॉलेज आ सकते हो चेक करवा लो अभी आते हो। हो सकता है कि आपका फिजिकल क्लास एग्जाम के बाद चालू हो जाए, बहुत शोर है कि नहीं? बहुत डिस्टर्बेंस है आपका साउंड में कॉलेज। ओके शंभुनाथ मोगल, मोगल के तो ऑलरेड बहुत जल्दी आ जाते थे। सुमित आहिरे उसके भी शीट तीन हो गए। योगेश शिंदे आपके कितने शीट है बेटा? योगेश योगेश है कि नहीं है? आर यू देयर योगेश? लोग तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, कुछ सब समझ में आ गया। इसका मतलब ये है चारों शीट ये जो ड्रॉ करना है आपको।
हेलो
हाँ बोलिए
सर, मेरे तीन शीट हो गए, तीसरा शीट सेंड किया है।
अच्छा तीन शीट हो गए, वेरी गुड है ना।
हाँ,
आप लोग सेंड करते रहो अभी, अगर फिजिकल क्लास नहीं चालू होती है तो ऑनलाइन में चेक करूंगा, और अगर फिजिकल क्लासेस हमारे चालू हो गए तो फिर आपको फिजिकली चेक करवाना पड़ेगा, इसलिए मैं अभी चेक नहीं कर रहा हूँ उसको। आप बना कर रखिए। बोलिए।
बट मैं नासिक से हूँ।
आप नासिक से हो या कहीं से भी हो, अब तो जब फिजिकल चालू होगा तो आएंगे ना कॉलेज?
हाँ सर आएगा, बीच में आएंगे।
हाँ तो जब भी आएंगे तो आप चेक करवाते रहिए आपके शीट्स जो भी कम्प्लीट हो। और आपके कुछ दोस्त दोस्त जो रेगुलर लेक्चर करेंगे उनसे कांटेक्ट में रहिए ताकि आप आपका लॉस ना हो। हाँ
ओके,
आप एक ग्रुप में हैं, आप फ्रेंड बनाइए ताकि आपको रेगुलर सब अपडेट मिलती रहे, और ग्रुप में ऐसे भी अपडेट मिलते रहती है आपको। गूगल क्लासरूम आप ज्वाइन की?
फ्रेंड एक्टिव नहीं है।
नहीं तो गूगल क्लासरूम पे तो सब डालता हूँ मैं, लर्निंग मटेरियल भी डालता हूँ, शीट्स डालता हूँ, ये सब आपके जो करना है काम वो डालता हूँ। फ्रेंड एक्टिव फ्रेंड बनाइए ना आप। 70 स्टूडेंट्स है, 70 स्टूडेंट में आपको एक्टिव फ्रेंड नहीं मिलते हैं। अभी देखो सुमित है, मुगल है, ये लोग
अपडेटेड रहते हैं। नहीं सर ग्रुप का है ना, ग्रुप है हमारा, तो उसमें ना एक भी बच्चा ऐसा है कि चैटिंग नहीं करता है, कि कुछ नहीं करता है।
नहीं आप करिए, देखो जो करेगा उसको अच्छी मार्क्स मिलेगी, जो नहीं करेगा उसको कम मार्क्स मिलेगी, है कि नहीं?
ओके।
और मार्क्स से कुछ नहीं होता, आप क्या सीखते हो उसको मानी रखते हैं। जो जो रहेगा जो ऑनलाइन क्लासेस करेंगे दे विल लर्न मोर, जो नहीं करेंगे उनको ऐसे भी सीखना नहीं है शायद। हम तो बार बार लिंक तो सबको भेजते हैं ना ग्रुप में, सब लोग ये भेजते हैं। दोस्त दे आर नॉट ज्वाइनिंग दे आर नॉट बॉन्ड फॉर देम। और कोई क्वेश्चन है तो आप पूछ सकते हैं, अदर मेरी स्टॉप हियर।